Welcome everybody to another ComfyUI Manager video. I am Dr.Lt.Data and today we're going to look at the double click feature. The double click feature is a feature attached to the title of each node. When you double click it, it will behave a certain way. When you work on a workflow, you will add nodes, and each node usually have inputs and outputs, and you need to connect these inputs and outputs. But it can be tedious, especially with nodes containing lots of inputs. That's where the double click feature is very useful. In our situation, we have a case sampler with four input and one output. If I double click on the title, ta-da, all the inputs will be connected and the output as well. The double click feature can be modified in the menu. You have different options, the node options, the copy all condition that we just saw, the copy input conditions that will connect only the inputs, the possible input connections, I will get back to that in a moment, and the last one combines two options. It combines the possible input connection if you click on the left side of the title, and the copy all connections if you click on the right side of the title. But first, let's have a look to the copy input connection. We saw earlier with copy all connections that if you double click, all the input and output will be connected. If you have selected the copy input connections and double click on the case sampler, it will only copy the input, no output. When you use the possible input connection, the behavior is very similar to the copy input connection. The only thing is that it will try to catch the proper connection one by one. In this case, we are looking at one model, two conditioning, and one latent. If I double click on the title, the feature will connect the model, one conditioning, and one latent, and it will get the closest one. So in this case, the model has picked the right one, the latent is the right one, but here the negative conditioning is connected to the positive conditioning. This is because technically both are the same and the negative is the closest to the positive. If I remove that connection and bring the node to the positive conditioning and double click again, it will trigger a connection between the positive output and the positive input. Now if I move the node to the negative and double click again, because we still have one conditioning left, it will connect the negative conditioning to the negative input. Now when using the possible left and copy right, you will be able to access two different types of behavior, like we said. On the right side, if I click on it, double click on it, you will connect everything. Now, if I only double click on the left side, I will only connect the input ones. One thing to take care of and to be careful about is that when you are using the copy all connection, it will actually copy the input properly, but the output will actually change a little bit your workflow. So if I double click now, we do have all the inputs here, which are correctly connected. And we do have our latent, which is correctly connected to the VA decode, But in this case, the VA decode was connected to the previous case sampler. So the connection have been removed after I double click the title of my new case sampler. You may need to be careful about that because your workflow might change. I hope this video was interesting and help you make better workflows. Thanks to everyone for watching. I'll speak to you soon. Goodbye.